Hi everyone, my name is Mridul and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys 10 super affordable makeup products that everyone should have. If you have these 10 makeup products, you're going to be sorted. This video could also be called kind of like a makeup starter kit for beginners. If you're someone who's starting to build their makeup collection, this is the way to go. These products are so good and, can I add once again, super affordable. Side note, let me know if you guys want an everyday signature makeup look tutorial on the look that I wear all the time using most of these products. Let me know in the comments down below. And without any further ado, let's just get started with today's video. So I'm going to be talking about 10 categories of makeup, and in each category I'm going to be giving you 2 options each so that you can pick and choose according to your skin type or even your preference. So the first category is foundation, and can you even guess which foundation I'm going to recommend? This just had to be in my list because it's so good. This is the Maybelline's Fit Me Foundation. Now, I know people who have extremely dry skin, oily skin, combination skin, even sensitive skin, and this foundation works for everyone. It's so, so good. I've been using this for so many years at this point and it just never gets old. This foundation is just something different altogether. By the way, this also comes in like a smaller travel version, so if you've never used this foundation before, you're missing out, number one. And number two, I would recommend going for the smaller one just so that you can try it out and get a feel for yourself. This foundation is medium coverage, however when I wear it, I cannot feel anything. Like, it's super lightweight is what I'm trying to say. But if you want something a little bit more full coverage, this is option number 2 for you. This is the Maybelline's Superstay 24-Hour Full Coverage Foundation. As the name suggests, this is a full coverage, or rather a higher coverage sort of a foundation. This is a little bit heavier, of course, because it is full coverage, but the finish is so, so beautiful. I usually wear this when I'm filming. I am wearing it even right now. But if you think this is too heavy for you, what you can do is you can mix it with the Fit Me. That's what I do a lot of times when I'm stepping out for like a more dressy occasion. I'll mix these two and it gives me like that beautiful in between. But you don't have to do that. You can pick whatever you want according to your priorities. If you're someone who goes to college, I would just say stick to this. You don't need this one. But if you want something more heavy, this is the way to go. On to concealers. I have again 2 options for you guys. Let's start with the more everyday one. This is the LA Girls Pro Conceal Concealer. I think this is my 3rd tube. It's so, so good. I used to wear this every day, like for an everyday basis when I would step out. Just put it under my eyes and then powder it off. Such a beautiful coverage, so lightweight. You can't even feel and tell like you're wearing makeup. It's that good. Definitely recommend this. But if you want something more full coverage, Maybelline's Age Rewind. I'm like completely out of it. Kuch bacha hi nahi hai isme. This on the other hand is very, very full coverage. Like if you have dark circles, oh my god, try this. It's gonna like erase everything. Now, as I said, it is full coverage, but it does not feel heavy under your eyes, which is the beautiful thing about this concealer. So yeah, these are my options for concealers. For an everyday, go for this one. So good, but thoda sa zyada chahiye camera ke liye ya fir for like occasions, shadi and all, this one is the way to go. Next up, powders. 2 options hai again. The first one is this Lakme's 9to5 Prime Plus Matte Powder Foundation is what it's called. It is a powder foundation, so you could wear this just on its own, but I like it as a setting powder for an everyday. So what I used to do was I would apply the Pro Conceal, LA Girl Pro Conceal Concealer, and then I would set it with this powder. It's such a beautiful combination. I would highly recommend this. I used to even like dust this all over my face sometimes, and it would just like mattify my skin and give it like an even coverage. Very, very beautiful powder. But when I'm filming, I can't use this because the coverage isn't good enough. That is when I use the Maybelline's Fit Me powder. This is the loose powder. Now I have to mix 2 shades. By the way, all the shades are going to be mentioned in the description box below. So I mix 2 shades and I use this to set under my eyes, my T-zone, all of that. This product is life-changing. I'm not exaggerating. It changed the way my makeup looked. after using this powder on my face, my skin looks very airbrushed, almost poreless. I don't want to say that about my own makeup, but I honestly could see such a huge difference by using this powder. It's so full coverage, so mattifying. It's just amazing. Like, honestly, I do have really oily skin, so this just works beautifully for me. It mattifies my skin, helps with oil control. But if you do have dry skin, don't worry, don't be scared of this loose powder. Just don't use as much. Like, I will like go in and bake and do all of that, but if you have dry skin, just use very little under your eyes and just dust it all over your face. It's not gonna dry out your face if you use it the right way. For the longest time, I didn't wear blush, and I started very recently and I am hooked. I'm obsessed. I have 3 product recommendations for you guys. Can you believe it? Let's start with a cream product. Now, this is the Faces Canada's Ultime Pro Liquid Blush, cream blush rather. This blush for an everyday basis is everything. It makes you look so healthy, so juicy. Like, your cheeks look so plump. It's so good. Like, definitely check out this product. It's really good. If you have dry skin, look no further. Get this. But if you have oily skin also, iska finish thoda matte hai, toh it's not gonna like make you oily. But if you want to stick to powder recommendations, don't worry, I have got you. This is the Wet n Wild's Color Icon Blush. This I use when I'm filming, so I'm wearing it even now. I don't apply too much, just like very little. I just dust it over my cheeks. This is great for camera and this is great for Indian skin tone. I have personally struggled a lot with finding blushes that suit my skin tone. This looks really pretty on Indian skin tone. Another blush that looks beautiful on Indian skin tone, but I prefer wearing this for like a more like real life occasion. So if I'm going out, I will wear this. This is the L'Oreal's blush and this is the shade Play With Me. This is very everyday wala blush, as I mentioned already, but this just kind of soaks into your skin almost. Like, you can't even tell like you're wearing blush, even though it's powder. Ekdam hi zyada like andar skin ke andar seep ho jata, and it looks natural and it gives you that glow also. I almost forgot to mention highlighters. I don't know how. Okay, let's start with the everyday version. This is the Nykaa's Strobe and Glow highlighter. So good. I mean, I know at this point I'm saying that about every product, but that is why it's in today's video. So this is like a glow from within highlighter. So if you don't like that chunky, glittery thing, and if you want something for every day, use this. I used to use this back in the day when we used to go out. A beautiful highlighter. But if you want like the chunky wala, full-on like highlight on fleek sort of a highlighter, try the Maybelline's Master Chrome Metallic Highlighter. This isn't like a chunky wala highlighter, but it's very, very like bam. Like, you know what I mean? This is like subtle glow, but this is like a full-on highlighter. So yeah, those are my highlighter picks. Okay, eyebrow products. A lot of you guys in the comments compliment me on my eyebrows, so thank you for that. I'm gonna talk about the products that I use. So everyday basis ke liye, this is the best eyebrow pencil that I have ever found. This is the Nykaa's Brow Girl Brow Definer. Why I love it, I'll tell you. So on one end, it has the most beautiful formulation wala eyebrow pencil. It's not too waxy, it's not too harsh, it's just perfect, honestly. Theek hai, ek side pe ye ho gaya, and on the other side it has a spoolie. So if you have this, you're not gonna need any other, like, you're not gonna need anything else. You're not gonna need a gel, you're not gonna need like a separate spoolie to comb out your brows. Everything's here. Trust me on this, if you've been looking for an eyebrow pencil, just get this. Like, you will thank me later. But for like filming days, I want my eyebrows to be more like structured and darker. Tabhi I will go in with the Miss Claire's Eyebrow Cake. Again, this is super affordable and there are so many shades to choose from. Another thing what I really like about this and why I'm even recommending to you guys is it comes with a brush. Theek hai, toh brush toh hai, usme angled brush hai, which is so good. I use the brush only, and then on the back it also has a spoolie, so it's again perfect. If you have this one, I've like broken it, sorry. If you have this one product, you're gonna be sorted. If I had to choose only between these two, I would go for the Nykaa brow pencil, because aisa nahi hai ki ye everyday mein use ho gaya, toh you can't use it for more special occasions. You can really like structure out your brows because it's a pencil, and just go a little bit heavy on the tail. So yeah, you can like multi-purpose with this totally. eyeliner. You guys know I love my wing liners. I'm always wearing a wing liner. So I had to like talk about eyeliner. I'm going to start with the most affordable product that I have probably in this list. And if you're an OG, you know what I'm going to say. This is the Lakme's Insta Liner. This liner used to be for like 99 rupees. Abhi, I think they've hiked up the price to 115 or 105, something on those lines. So still it's very, very affordable. But this product is just so good. Like in general, it just performs so well. It's so black. The brush tip is perfect so that you can like really make your wing like a precise wing. It's just a great product. Like if you don't want to spend too much of money, but you still want a good eyeliner, definitely go for this. But another eyeliner that I have been loving recently and I'm over with, okay, by the way, you can't even see the packaging, like you can't even see the name that was printed on it because of how much I've used it. This is the Nykaa's Wink in a Blink, I think that's what it's called. So on one end it has the felt tip liner and on the other end it has the stamp. This is one of the best products by Nykaa. I feel like the felt tip liner is perfect. Like you could really go in and make thick strokes, but if you want ekdam patli precise lines bhi aati hai. The liner is so good, so black, stays on forever. But at the same time, when you want to get rid of it, it comes off also, like with a proper makeup remover. If you want something a little bit more heavy duty as compared to this, go for this one. You're not gonna regret it. So good. On to mascara. Now, mascaras are one of my favorite makeup products. Like if I could choose only say like three makeup products, one of the three has to be mascara. I have two mascara recommendations. The first one is the Lakme's Kareena Kapoor Khan mascara. I've completely run out of it and for some reason I can't find it online. So if you know where I can find it, please let me know in the comments down below. Honestly, it is a little bit better than the Lash Sensational, which is mascara number two that I'm going to recommend, the Maybelline's Lash Sensational. Again, that's a mascara that I've been using for years. I think like 4 or 5 years at this point. It's so, so good. Very affordable. The Lakme's Kareena Kapoor Khan mascara is a little bit more expensive as compared to the Lash Sensational. So if you just want one cheap mascara, go for the Lash Sensational because it's very good quality. Like it will lengthen and volumize. It's going to do everything. Like it's a beautiful mascara. Eyeshadow palette recommendation time. So I have two palettes for you guys. The first one is like an everyday, more neutral sort of a palette. This is the Makeup Revolution's Soph X palette. So as you can see, the colors are very neutral. There are a lot of browns, orange tones, thode metallics bhi hai beech beech mein. There's like some purple, pink, red, but it's more on the neutral side. So great for an everyday. There are some beautiful like metallic highlighter shades as well, which I use for highlight. Some beautiful shades for eyebrow filling also. Beautiful blush color, contour color. So waise to you can like really multi-purpose with this palette, which is why I picked this. But if you really want to like experiment and if you want a colorful eyeshadow palette, this is the Makeup Revolution's Tropical Carnival eyeshadow palette. I've accidentally broken one color, but as you can see, there are so many colors to pick from. There are reds, oranges, yellows, blues, purples, greens, some metallics, black bhi hai isme. Like it's like a full-on beautiful palette. Thoda sa inconsistency hai ye palette mein, matlab in terms of jaise the yellow is not as vibrant, but most of the other colors are like super pigmented. Like look at the red, look at the blue. So for the affordable price range, I think this is a great palette because there are so many colors to choose from also. And the quality is not the best, but it's pretty good. The quality of this palette is actually very good. I would say almost all the colors are really highly pigmented. They're not chalky. So all the products perform equally, like in terms of their consistency, feel and pigmentation. And the last category that I wanted to add are lashes. Now, you don't necessarily need lashes for a starter makeup kit, but I thought I would just like include it just in case because so many of you guys also ask me for my lash recommendations. So I'll give you two. The first one is a natural one, which is by PAC. It is the 03 Pro 03 wala variation. Don't worry, I'll link it down below. That looks beautiful for like an everyday. I mean, you don't have to wear lashes for an everyday, but you know what I mean, right? More natural. But one thing I will say about that lash is you can't use it for like more than 2-3 times. So I feel like it's just such a waste of money buying that pair of lash, but it's beautiful nonetheless, so I wanted to mention it. The second pair of lash is by Rene. It's called Ash, that fiery one. Now this lash used to be actually really expensive. It used to be for 1,000 rupees. Now they've removed like a new version. I think they've switched up the packaging or what, but the lash inside is still the same, and now it's for 500 rupees. I'll make sure to link that also in the description box below. So you're getting the same pair of lashes for half the price, and you can use these lashes for 20 plus times. So kidar nahi, like I use them for like 25 to 30 times because I'm like a cheapo like that. I will like save and like clean my lashes and take care of them. By the way, if you want a lash application video, I'm gonna link it down below. I've already done it, but that's not the point of this video. I would recommend going for these lashes because you get your like money's worth as compared to pack wale lashes are cheap. I think those are for like 295 or something like that, but just not worth it because you're gonna have to toss them out. Yeah, that's it for today's video. Those were my top 10 makeup products, or like top 10 categories jisme I showed you like maybe like 20-25 products. So yeah, you can pick and choose according to your preferences. I'm gonna make sure to link all the products down below. Don't forget to subscribe and click on the little bell to get notified every single time I post a new video. Don't forget to let me know if you want a tutorial on this look. I would love to do it. Follow me on my Instagram and follow Simba Lifestyle. I'll see you very soon in my next video. Bye.